I start off this series with the king of the TLRs and probably the camera company most known for TLRs, Rolle. And this is the Rolleiflex Automat 1. And I can't look at all the Rolleiflexes because it would probably get crazy expensive. And this is the one I had on hand. So this is Automat 1. And in the front, you're going to see these two winding knobs. And the winding knobs actually control aperture and shutter speed. On the front of the camera, you're also going to see two ports. There's the sync port there, so flash sync port there. And then on the right, there's a self timer. On the bottom of the camera, you're going to also see a shutter release port and a safeguard release. So on the top, since you're looking down in the camera, it makes sense to have the shutter speed and the aperture look on the top of the lens like this. So, and it's, I think it's really cool looking. So I've never seen a camera with this before, and I think it's really clean. And it's really interesting to look at. And remember again that when you're using a TLR, most people are looking down into the viewfinder. So this makes sense to have it there. So here's the focusing mechanism, and it's pretty interesting. On most cameras, you're not going to see this, but this one, the lenses move forward and backwards. So it allows this camera to be a little bit smaller since there's no helical like on a regular lens. And so basically this controls the focusing, and it's a pretty crude system. It moves that lenses forward and back. But even though it's crude, these are some of the best built cameras. This is probably one of the best built cameras I've ever handled. Here you're going to see the back. There's a pretty cool exposure chart. And here's the winding mechanism. And you can see the film kind of right there too. But just every single part of this camera feels like it's very well made. It feels great in your hand, and it has a heft to it, which I look for in vintage cameras. And I really enjoyed handling it. And I actually picked up a Rolle cord after, and the quality level is a little bit different, but still really high for Rolle cameras. So here you're gonna see the viewfinder. And there's a lot of accessories. So the back is a speed viewer, and this is also kind of like a close-up viewer, so you can really dial in your settings. And on the left, I'm going to focus with the focus dial. And so shooting like this, shooting down into the viewfinder, I think you get different images. And when I see the images that come out of this camera, they feel more natural. So even when people are taking people are having portraits with them, they just feel a little bit more natural. And I think it's because it's less threatening than someone putting a camera up to their face when someone's shooting at their hip. Practically, it makes it so it's a little bit easier to take that picture, I believe. And so the images with the Rolle that I saw were just felt a little bit different than the ones you would normally see with an SLR. So how do you load your film? First of all, there's two latches here, and I'm not going to load the film since this is in my camera, and I was just handling it for a couple minutes. So you open up those latches, and on the bottom, there's another latch. You move it over there, and then you're able to pull back on it. And it's like most 120 format film cameras. You're going to put your film there into the left spool, and then spool it into a another spool right there, and then you remove that spool when you're done shooting. And you're gonna use a winder to wind it. Also, there's a little window right there to see where you are in your film for the 120. So putting it back on, you line up those little tabs again, and you lock it in, and then lock it back up. So now we're going to look at some images from some photographers on Flickr, and they were gracious enough to let me use their images. This first image is from Christopher, and it's a landscape of Mount St. Helens, and I believe it's really strong. And when I saw it come on the screen, I was like, wow, that's amazing. So I asked him if I could use it, and he talked a little bit about it. He's been using a Rolle cord for about 30 years, and he's using a Rolle panorama head. And the thing I like about this image is, and I'll show it both ways, long and then scrolling it, is that there's a lot of focus points. So my eye, when I was looking at this, it's shooting around to a lot of different areas. There's the mountain, there's a peak in the center of it, but there's also peaks all around. And I like the lines and his use of contrast. So technically this is pretty difficult to do to get these, to get the framing right on this. And then to also get the contrast right on every single one. And I think he does it perfectly. And I just really like the black, how the black and white really brings out the texture in the mountains. So a really strong image from Christopher. Next is this image from R.P. Thomas, and this one's kind of personal. So I grew up in California, and we used to drive through Northern California all the time. And when you drive to Northern California, you see that there's these rolling hills like this, and it's grass as far as you can see. In the very far background, you can see these little light poles too. And you can see a lot more detail in a TLR because it's shooting on medium format film, and you just get a lot more detail shooting on bigger film. And this really displays it. This image really displays it. I also like his use of colors, so the blue contrasting against the browns of the grass. And there's a lot of cool contrast, compositional stuff going on too. So there's rolling in the hills, and there's rolling in the clouds. And there's also this really cool S shape that begins at the beginning of the bottom of the frame and rolls through the valley. So a really strong image, and it really reminds me of when I was a kid. So personally, I like it personally, and I like it compositionally. The next one is from Jet, and this is of a 1947 Dodge. I believe it's a truck. And it's a really cool image for me because I just like the sharpness in the license plate. So when you're shooting medium format, you get this extra sharpness, and you can really see it in this license plate. It looks amazing. And there's also, what drew me into it was there's a lot of good contrast going on, and there's also a lot of squares. So compositionally, there's the square in the license plate, the square in the back of the truck, the square in the truck itself, and it kind of all draws you in to different places. And his exposure is spot on, and the colors are spot on, and I like the reflections going on. So just a really cool image from Jet. This image really stuck out to me, and it's from a really cool set of images from Caspar. And I'm not sure where he took it. He says he went to, and in the description in the Flickr says it was an abandoned resort. But this image really stood out to me when I came across it. And you can see that there's this woman at the end of a dock, and there's a lot of texture on the dock. You can see it's worn down. There's missing planks. But the planks that are there are kind of leading into her, and she's like a really soft focal point. But also there's texture in the water, there's texture in the wood, and the canyons in the water kind of meet at where her head is. So I just really like this composition. There's a lot of great stuff going on, and the exposure is perfect. And the rest of the set is just as good as this, so definitely check it out. So this last one is from Daniel Espinoza, and this one also is a kind of personal one. So I used to do some figure drawing for a couple of years, and rarely do you draw stuff like this. So in figure drawing class, you're always taught to make lines a little longer and a little smooth and a little more natural. But here you're going to see that from far away, I couldn't even tell if this person was bending forwards or bending backwards or their orientation of their body. And he has it set up in a really interesting way. So you see a lot of the texture in the body, and you see a lot of the lines, and they're not always smooth. They're kind of, they kind of start and stop abruptly. And I think that's really cool. Some really cool things compositionally are there's a lot of great shadows and highlights, and there's also some cool texture. So on the top of the person, you're going to see some leaves, and they're crumbled, and they're dry, and the background's also kind of crumbled, but the body itself is very smooth, and is very smooth and very relaxed. So I just like what is going on there. And it does look like almost abstract, and a lot more, it looks like more shapes than a human body. So from far away, you probably couldn't tell this was a human body or a figure, but close up, when you look at it long enough, you can. And to me, it's just interesting. It brought me in, and seeing it come across the search was really cool. So remember to check out Daniel's and the other photographers' Flickr pages and photography pages in the description. And thank you to them for letting me use their images, and they're great images. It's easy to see that Rolleiflex takes amazing images, and it does because it has a slightly different format. It's more square than your traditional format, so it kind of breaks you out of a certain way of thinking and allows you to think in a new way and compose in a new way, which is really interesting and something I'm gravitating towards too, a more square format. And the second part is you're holding it differently. So with a normal SLR or a normal rangefinder, you're holding it to your face, and you're looking almost directly, and the camera's looking at how you're looking at the person or at the subject. But here you can hold it a little bit lower, and I think that's a little bit less intimidating for the person being photographed or the thing being photographed, and for the photographer, you can kind of blend in a little more. And there's some famous photography that's coming out from Vivian Meyer, who shot a lot with TLRs, and this is the same kind of vibe. It almost seems like she's capturing a lot more intimate moments, and that's what I feel like the Rolleiflex is doing. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, remember to like it. And if you like these type of videos, remember to subscribe to my channel, and we're going to do some more TLRs in the upcoming weeks. Thank you. Bye.